It's actually now week four for our summer math reading program, and I'm going to give you the answers to last week's Eulerian circuits part two. It said, circle each graph that has an Eulerian circuit. Put an X through each one that does not. Well, you'll notice I didn't put an X through the ones that didn't. I circled the ones that worked. So if you did these and realized you could not do it without tracing over a line, you are correct, because only these two actually worked. And if you're interested to find out why that works, I would take some time to look up Eulerian circuits online and find out what properties make them work and what properties make them not work. Hi, welcome to week number four of summer math program at the Rock Island Public Library with Miss Elizabeth. Today we are going to look at fabulous fractals or fantastic fractals. What are fractals? That's a funny word. It sounds a little like fractions. We're going to look at what this book says, Mysterious Patterns, Finding Fractals in Nature by Sarah C. Campbell. This is a really unusual vegetable, which I've never seen in a grocery store, but that's not the most interesting pattern. We're going to kind of look in and see what's happening with nature. And I think it's really interesting because we've been talking about a lot about topology and some shapes, and we want to look at how does nature grow. And nature actually grows mathematically. And we look at a fern, and if we keep looking, like the shape of the fern, if we keep going down at a microscopic level, it's really like a repetition of itself. So we have this concept here of this fractal nature. It starts here, it branches, it keeps branching, it keeps branching, it keeps branching. And you'll notice that this becomes a tree. Well, the unusual thing is that if you think about it, lightning looks like this in the sky, and actually our blood vessels inside our body does the same thing. It's all this branching. And when we discover what's really happening, mathematicians call this fractals. So we're going to look at, you can see, oh look, inside of our body, we have fractals inside of us, just like trees, just like plants, just like a pineapple, just like caterpillars. All right, so today the thing that I want us to look at is we're going to make our own fractal. And I know this is computer generated and looks really cool, and actually it's a 3D representation. But what we're going to do is we're going to use paper and pencil, and we're going to build our own Sierpinski triangle. Inside your packet, you should have an equilateral triangle template. Now, you could look online and or check out a book, or maybe your parents remember from geometry and figure out how to draw an equilateral triangle using a string, a ruler, and a pencil. But we just thought we'd save some time by using this handy-dandy equilateral triangle template. All right, so we have this template, and I'm going to show you how I use this template to draw another triangle. So I put a white piece of paper on top, and I got my ruler out. And really what I did was I just found the corners, the vertices, and I marked them. And then I just used my ruler. Instead of trying to line up the line to the line, I found it easier to mark it from vertex to vertex. So if you mark the vertex to vertex and use your straight edge, your ruler, and your pencil, you can make a copy of the template. So then what I did was I took my scissors and I cut it out. So you can see that I cut it out, okay? And then what I did was I used this template, instead of tracing around the triangle, which you could do, I decided to use this template. And actually what I did was I matched the bottom edge of my paper to the bottom edge, so that meant one less cut, one fewer cuts. And then I marked this vertex there, and I just came here
and marked this edge and marked this edge and I marked this edge and I came down here and marked this edge. And then what I did was I just used my scissors, and you could cut, you could mark the whole thing if it's easier for you. And what I did was I took my scissor and I was able to cut out the triangle like this. Okay? So once we have a couple of triangles, and I made a number of different colored triangles. So we want to have one triangle that we keep whole, and I kept it white. And then we want to mark, we want to cut, we want, because we're going to mark these and create smaller equilateral triangles. So the way we do that is we're going to measure the side of each triangle. So they should be the same. So I get to my inches side and I measure, and my triangle is 6 inches. So I'm going to go to 3, because 3 is half of 6. And I make a mark on my triangle. Then I go to the other side, and it should be 6 because it's equilateral. Remember, equilateral means all the sides and the angles are the same. So we're going to cut 6 in half. Remind me what that is. That's right, 3. You got it. 6 cut in half is 3. And then we move to the other side and we do the same thing. Get to 6, go to 3, and make a mark. Now, that's called the midpoint of that side. And what we're going to do now is we're going to draw a line from midpoint to midpoint. And then I just turn my triangle and I find the midpoint and I connect it to the other midpoint. And then I turn my triangle again and I match midpoint to midpoint. And what you'll see is I have divided my equilateral triangle into 4 equilateral triangles. So I'm going to cut them. Now the next trick is we do it again. That's the fractal aspect, because we just keep going. Remember I said we start and we keep getting smaller and smaller and smaller. It works the other direction too. So we remember that this should be 3, and it is. Okay, now half of 3 is a little tricky, right? Because we have 3 fingers and we can't cut in half evenly with our fingers. But if I cut my finger in half, oh, don't do it at home, we would have 1.5. So if we had $3, we would have $1.50. So we're going to look for 1.5 on our ruler. The halfway mark is kind of the big marking on your ruler that shows halfway. So we're going to go to 1.5, and I'll make sure I can see that. Turn the triangle. Every side should be 3. And we'll go to 1.5 again. And then we'll turn our triangle and we'll go to 1.5 again. So you get a lot of good practice to find where's 1.5. Remember, you go to 1 and you go halfway to 2. That's 1.5. All right, same thing we did before. We found the midpoints and now we're going to connect them and we're going to make smaller equilateral triangles. Look at that. So now we cut it. All right, so here's what we're going to do. I took one of my larger equilateral triangles, so I cut this one and I did this, and we're going to put this right here in the center like that. So actually, I'm going to turn this so it looks like a triangle to you, the viewer. All right, so you can see, right, like that it's in the middle between these two triangles, and there would be a triangle on top. Now, the other ones that we cut, when we took this and we measured, it was 3, and we did 1.5, that I did in yellow. So I'm going to come in, and I'm going to do the same. So in that little white triangle, I'm going to do the same thing that I did here. I'm going to put this here, and then I'm going to take another triangle and put it over here. And if you once you get the hang of it, you could use a little tape, or you could use some, a glue stick, and have this be a little more permanent. But I like to just do it at first just to see what it looks like. So, oopsie. There we go. We're just going to get the idea of what needs to happen here. So that's going to fit right about there. All right. So the next thing I did was I took one of these small triangles. And remember, we have to measure, it's going to be 1.5. And what is half of $1.50? So if you think about money, I'm going to say $1.50 has, a dollar has 4 quarters, 50 has 2 quarters, so that's 4 plus 2 is 6, and I can cut 6 in half, right? 6 cut in half, we already decided, was 3. So 3 quarters would make 75 cents. So what we're looking for on our ruler is 3 quarters. So if this is the half mark, we're going to say this line here is 1 quarter, 2 quarters would be half, and here's 3 quarters. So that's where you're going to actually take this and make the mark, and you're going to cut it, and it's going to look like this. So I'm going to let you do the measuring at home, and I already cut out my little triangles. So we're going to do the same thing. So if this is my little white triangle right here, I'm going to put that right there. And if this is my little white triangle, I'm going to put this one right here. And I'm going to put this one right here. So obviously you're going to continue to cut, and you're going to fill in all the places. And when you finish, you will have made a Sierpinski triangle. And if you feel like it, you could just keep cutting smaller and smaller and smaller and see where you go. So this is Fractals, Fabulous, Fantastic Fractals.